I can't seem to get much sleep.
A Gurkha knife, just like father's.
You are looking rather rickish, don't you?
Not my name. If a man don't take pride in his hair.
Not lunch cross on our pockets, check the ledger!
You ain't got. What's sixpence to your name?
Thank you.
I wondered what you were up to, Jake.
There's always a new challenge ahead, Jacob.
Thank you.
Been a killing, maybe two.
This is. God, this is Michel Rouge's vault.
Michael Rouge's vault? It can't be.
You have no idea who that is, do you?
I'm the foggiest.
He was an assassin. Father had one of his books. Legend says he found some fabulous treasure near Bath that drove him mad. He locked it away beneath London, in a vault that could only be opened by a set of special musical boxes.
Special musical boxes? Now who's mad?
Thank you. Something is going on.
Come on, you silly man.
No, it wasn't me. Not guilty. Beg your pardon. You're the one.
I assure you, we've never met.
Is this a prize fighting ring? You bet your eyes and ears it is, my lord. My lady. The name's Robert Toppin. Best bookie in all of London, at your disposal. Well, second best, but my mum says Dom's a bit of a nincompoop. Anyhow, I can show you a vast array of exciting things. From prize fights to carriage races.
I think we can afford to spend a little time here.
Anybody fancy a challenge?
Good to have you. I was beginning to worry I'd have to take on these boots myself.
Ladies and gentlemen, you may want to place your bets on this fine contestant.
You've got good instincts leaving early. My mother would commend you for it. Me? I always stay until my pockets are empty and my spirits are dampened.
Thank you.
best in the old city.
I'll eat your eye.
Come on, you silly man.
Doing fine, girl. Steady on. That's the way. Walk on, girl. Let's go.
Oh, blast them.
Alec, whatever is the matter?
I have been intercepting nothing but poppycock propaganda about soothing syrup and whatnot. No, I swear to high heavens, if Starek's monopoly continues...
Alec, I beg your pardon. These are friends of mine. Evie Fry and her brother, Jacob.
Alexander Graham Bell.
Linguist, inventor, and technical expert. Alec, I have something of a favor to ask you.
Can you fix this?
Oh, looks like the casing is cracked. Oh, comes apart. I see. Could have used one of these to fit my fuses on top of Big Ben.
Alec is installing a new telegraph line for our Free Press Association.
To combat the Starek Telegraph Company. Now, if I can mend the fuses connecting independent lines from Big Ben, Starek will be weakened. Only, we are somewhat at a handicap. And, there. Oh, I've removed the mechanism, so it may work with your bracer.
I'll put it to use immediately.
Jacob, wait. Mr. Bell, allow me to help you with your fuses.
Oh, you will not find me too proud to accept Miss Fry. Or, we can use my carriage, if you'd be so good as to hold the reins, though.
I'll take that.
I can help you.
Oh, Miss Fry, I am so glad you could assist me. You really ought to...
So, Mr. Bell, what inventions are you concocting?
I intend to develop a phonetic telegraph that does not just convey dots and dashes,
Master!
Miss Fry, but human voice.
Phonetic telegraph? Sounds a bit of a mouthful. You could just call it a telephone.
Telephone? How bizarre. Anyway, as I was saying earlier, the press has become entirely dependent on the Starek Telegraph Company.
Which is why Mr. Green has asked you to set up a free line.
Yes. What is more, other small independent companies have their lines sabotaged, and they have little means of finding any broken fuses, which are...
to be found on top of Big Ben.
correct, especially as one. Pass to get through the guards?
They will not be a problem. I'll repair the fuses. Lovely view. Set.
Thank you.
That should do it.
Thank you very much, Miss Fry. I will now be able to continue with the installation of the new line.
If there's anything else I can do to help...
Certainly. Please do come and visit. I was toying with this device and have noted down the formula for you. It's not perfect yet, but by golly, it works.
coming over and teaching you a...
How'd you work that out?
Take Mr. Gladstone. Everyone knows he's a night walker, right? But what if news spreads? He does more than walking and talking to your lilies and your holly.
Cables for then.
Thank you.
Miss Fry, I was just showing Jacob the first message was received via the mended lines. Oh, you can keep the rope launcher, by the way. We've managed to procure another one for your brother. Excellent work. Thank you, again.
You're very welcome, Mr. Bell.
We can now defend the principle of impartial news and free speech.
Free is fair, but free and brief is far better.
Ha ha! Ah, Fry, such caustic wit.
And on that note, we must depart.
Good fortune to you both. Call on me at any time.
Now that we've finished with that distraction...
Who is that?
Oh, you mean... you don't know?
Beautiful train you got here. Miss McBean was just telling me all about her. Name's Ned.
How do you do?
I won't take up more of your time. If you want to learn a thing or two about the finest transit systems in the world, you can find me at this address.
Let us return to locating the Peace of Eden.
We need to reclaim London from Starrick. Who are my targets?
It's not time for that yet.
I didn't come to London to hunt curios.
First understand the dance, only then become the dancer.
Oh, so you're taking over where Father left off.
Someone has to.
Evie, finding the precursor artifact will give us an insight into what the Templars intend. Jacob, I have information about Starrick's associates that should be of use to you. Here.
This soothing syrup has become the only medicine available in Lambeth. It bears the Templar Grandmaster's name.
About time for a visit to the doctor.
I don't see that cure arriving anytime soon.
And what exactly will you be doing, might I ask?
You know very well. Tracking down the Peace of Eden.
Enjoy your studies. I'll be out killing Templars.
That's a nicely cut suit.
There's a scaffold over there.
oil the engine and the lads disappeared. Must be off getting oil himself. Could you drag him back here for me? Much appreciated.
Look at this mess. Young bum boozer comes in here, argues with the regulars, rattles their cage. I don't need problems like that.
Did you see where Bob went, mate?
What? Bob?
I'm looking for Bob the Apprentice.
Yeah, I seen him. Looked like he was about to vomit. I told him to get out of it. He went to throw up in the alley.
Can a man have a bit of privacy? Yeah, a drunk bloke.
group of bashers followed him.
Blood. This doesn't look sunny for Bob.
He's crossed the wrong blokes, he has. Think I'm a jolter, do ya?
Lovely. Come on, then. We're fast friends now, aren't we? To the hospital, shall we?
This has been quite an adventure.
That's the way.
Yeah! 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 Too fast! The stomach's in a whirl! Yeah! Keep your eyes on the road there, mate! Slow down! We passed another pump!
Yeah!
Whoa! Real too fast there!
Doing fine, girl.
Where's the cab ride of me life? She was a pretty little gosling.
That's a girl.
Stuck like a pig. Here, I'll stitch you up.
I'll be needing something to numb the pain.
I'll get my whiskey.
Could you make a gin?
A Gurkha knife, just like father's.
That's the last mistake you'll ever make. You cheeky sod, wait till I get them.
Oh dear.
Dear. This is going very badly, isn't it?
It certainly doesn't have the makings of a ripping good novel.
What happened here?
Ah! The charming and delightful Fry twins.
Have we met?
Mr. Raymond knows everyone. He knows everything about this city. He writes it all up in his books.
I'm Henry Raymond, writer of third-rate, lurid stories. Penny dreadfuls, if you will. And this is little Artie.
Mr. Raymond takes real murders and makes them so awfully exciting. The guilty always get caught.
There's one unfolding just here. Perhaps one of you would like to try your hand in solving it.
Crime so delightfully entertaining, don't you? I mean, solving crimes, of course. Finding a solution is exhilarating.
I arrived to find the foreman dead, and the lad Dooley with bloody hands. No one's been able to find the murder weapon and arrest the murderer. Could you sort it out quickly? It's holding up the work. I arrived to find the foreman dead, and the lad Dooley with bloody hands. No one's been able to... I arrived to find the foreman dead, and the lad Dooley with bloody hands. No one's been able to... I arrived... They're a rough bunch, but someone has to keep the kids in line. I just wish the grown-ups would quit fighting each other.
He's my brother. He don't like to work hard, so one of the workers give him a thrashing. I tried to stop it, and he stops hitting Buck and starts hitting me. He knocks me to the ground and give me a kick. I find my work knife under me and grab it. I lift my hands to protect myself, and he knocks me out with a punch. Later on, I wakes up, and the man's lying there, dead.
Come back, the man's lying dead, and there's Dooley holding a knife. Please don't arrest him. I was standing there, having a think, when a fella come at me and give me a thumping. Dooley tries to stop him, and he thrashes Dooley. I run out to find help.
Thank you.
He knocks me to the ground and give me a kick. I find me work knife under me and grab it. I lift me hands to protect myself, and he knocks me out with a punch. Later on, I wakes up, and the man's lying there, dead. He's my brother. He don't like to work hard, so one of the workers give him a thrashing. I tried to stop it, and he stops hitting Buck and starts hitting me.
I arrived to find the foreman dead, and the lad Dooley with bloody hands. No one's been able to find the murder weapon and arrest the murderer. Could you sort it out quickly? It's holding up the work. They're a rough bunch, but someone has to keep the kids in line. I just wish the grown-ups would quit fighting each other.
Someone could tell me more about this.
That's Dooley's knife, all right. He never lent it to nobody.
Why would I kill a perfectly productive worker? Not so quickly. You have indeed solved this murder, according to the facts at hand. However, Artie, what advice would you give?
I would encourage you to look beyond the obvious, beyond surface appearances.
Try again. Use your powers to peer more deeply and see what you can discover.
Which suspects had the opportunity to kill him? would the murderer have done it? Which suspects had the opportunity to kill him?
Wilkins wasn't the type to beat the children. On the contrary, he was forever getting in fights, trying to stop that sort of thing. The fumes can be a bit much in the brewery. When the men work in there, they wear bandanas. They're a rough bunch, but someone has to keep the kids in line. I just wish the grown-ups would quit fighting each other.
Suspects had the opportunity
to
kill
him. Now that I've seen this, I should ask more questions.
Went to see what it was about and never come back. I went to see for myself, and there he was, dead. I didn't stick around. Somebody might think I'd done it. The strange thing is, Wilkins weren't wearing no bandana when I was talking to him. Only the workmen in the brewery wear bandanas. You should talk to Morris there.
I was inside the brewery all day. I wear me bandana in there. Man asked you, what with all the smells and fumes.
Refresh your memory.
try to establish a motive.
Now that I've seen this, I should ask more questions.
I don't much know who smokes here. Maybe Taylor? Cigarette might be his.
Smoking months ago. You know, I saw somebody from the brewery having a smoke this morning. Didn't see who it was, though.
Well, like I said, I was inside. Didn't get a chance to come out to smoke. Colton left, though. You could talk to him. He's working in the loading area just now.
Now that I've seen this, I should ask more questions.
You can always check your case file to refresh your memory.
I don't smoke. Never did. I was having a chat with one of the others when I heard a commotion and ran in there to find Wilkins dead. Poor bloke. Killed by that filthy little bastard that we feed and pay. Oh, very well. So I do smoke now and then. What's the matter? I should be foreman here. Wilkins coddled the boys like a mother hen. He come along and stops me giving the boys a beating.
That was much more difficult than it initially appeared. Well done.
Up to the clique with you!
Thank you.
something strange going on.
Fly away home.
Why don't I rip your red head off?
Roll up your ass.
Ooh.
No noise, just walk.
What's that? Someone's up to no good.
This is gonna hurt. This does not concern you. I'm in trouble now.
You should make it a point to make several good points.
Are you running from me?
You
better!
I would like a 7-inch flywheel, please.
Hang on a minute. Damn it. I can't get a blessed thing done around here.
Miss Evie! I done something dreadful! The train won't stop!
Keep your flywheel.
Ugh. is bursting into flame. Climb round and put out the fires while I fix the brakes.
These fires won't put themselves out.
Where does this blasted thing go?
I need to be quick. Damn fires keep cropping up! I can't let these fires take hold. Top of this. Seconds left. What was that? I better check on the driver.
Thank you. things. So much variety.
Ah, solid okay. Good for putting a bit of steel in it.
Ah, another exciting night home for Evie Fry.
Just on my way out, actually. I found the Peace of Eden.
What's this one going to do, hmm? Heal the sick? Deflect bullets? Control the populace?
They're dangerous objects, Jacob, especially in Templar hands.
Oh, you sound exactly like Father.
If only. Lucy Thorne is expecting a shipment tonight. She's Starrick's expert in the occult. I'm nearly certain she is receiving the Peace of Eden Sir David Brewster mentioned.
Sounds like fun. Mind if I join you?
Promise you will stick to the mission.
I swear.
The contents of that box are worth more than your life and those of your entire family. Do you understand?
Yes, Miss Thorne.
Careful there! And double the guard on that cart!
Now, Miss Thorne, there's the matter of some papers for Mr. Starrick. If you'll just come this way.
Very well, but make it quick.
Whatever it is she's after, it's in that chest.
There are gunmen on the rooftops.
Can you dispose of them before I reach the cart?
I was hoping for a challenge.
Oh.
Hunter!
Actually.
There he is!
I think it's best we leave.
What did you do?
It's hardly the time for questions!
Whoa! Come on!
That's my cue to leave.
Pray I don't cross the street! You asked
me to come over.
We need to get this crate back to a safe place!
What do you think I'm trying to do?
As a man, I say kill us both!
Steady on. Walk on, girl.
Would you drive a little more carefully? You're endangering the documents!
Oh, poor documents! Perhaps you'd rather I just stop right here!
Let's go. Who's a good horse?
We need to get this crate back to a safe place!
What do you think I'm trying to do?
And again!
That's the way.
Let's do it again.
Damn it.
Train for you. Lick of paint, new rugs from Camden Loch, and my wee sister, the seamstress, did a discount on the curtains.
Cane gives you an undeniable air of joie de vivre.
How's your evening, Evie?
What an enjoyable day. What with Miss Thorne and the papers and all.
Ugh. Get Starek's soothing syrup right here!
It's all he drinks. Your syrup is liquefying him. He's turning him simple-headed.
Now, look now. You are scaring away my customers. Why don't you bugger off or I'll give you something to remember me by?
You can't talk to me like that, you little gutterling.
What's all this then?
Oh, sod off!
If you'll excuse me, madam.
Thank you.
need.
I am your master!
Tell me where the syrup originates.
How wonderful!
I think I'll take...
Let's find out where that syrup is made, shall we? The man in charge of the syrup distribution runs a fighting club at the Foundry. Thank you. Where is the syrup, mate? Speak now or forever hold your...
The distillery. It's the large building beside the brewery.
Now, to stop soothing syrup production once and for all.
Thank you. Jacob, Miss Fry, how good to see you. Oh, have you seen Starlik's latest lies?
Lies in a newspaper?
What transpired from the new line you're establishing?
Oh, the cables we ordered never arrived. And then we intercepted this. A message mentioning cargo seized at College Wharf.
Then let's unseize it.
Oh, wait. Another intercepted wire contained the recipe for a powerful hallucinogenic serum. I've adapted this dart mechanism to work with your bracers.
Alec, you're a genius.
Well, that patently is untrue. Although I've also discovered that the serum adopts a form of a gas when subjected to heat.
Just when I think you can't surpass yourself.
A good horse. You are.
Next time, make sure you're working for the right people, you lummox. Don't worry. We'll see your cables get delivered. They've got themselves a new destination.
stir up some trouble. Go. On your orders. Stay put.
I'm with you.
Fall in. Don't move a furlong.
On your orders. Trouble.
What are you on about?
I'll cover your back.
Wait here.
Thank you.
docks, lads! We need to get this load to Starek now!
Make yourself scarce. Poison. Bell must know what kind.
Thank you.
careful there, Mr. Bell.
Every worthwhile endeavor is fraught with dangers, my dear friends. None more so than yours. But you have triumphed once again. How do you know? We have entered the age of communication, remember? We've already received word from Greenwich that the shipment has arrived safely, thanks to you.
Have you discovered what else is in that shipment?
Indeed. I'm afraid that Starek's poison has found its way onto the open market.
If he believes that will stop us, he is mistaken.
I've got something to tell you.
Dressed to the nines, Alf.
A pleasant day. I had an uncle was a ruler of all England 11. I wish you a pleasant afternoon.
Thank you.
Ledger reads like a tragedy.
What an enjoyable
day. I need a wee bit of advice.
What with Miss Thorne and papers and all.
These past few days when I've been doing my round, some bampot starts following me.
Never
spoken. He's up to no good.
Tell you what, do your rounds as usual. If he appears, I'll keep an eye on him. When we return, put him into the train.
Aye. All right.
Evie, a man couldn't have a better sister.
Hijackings, raids, robberies, so much variety.
Thank you.
Agnes, take care. There's a gang out looking for you.
Ugh, not at all. Just one glacial laddie following me.
You certain?
Certain as can be.
These streets aren't safe at night.
See?
Limar saw a man get pinked over a locket he found in the mud.
There he is, the rascal.
Damn, Pillock.
Sorry, but that woman's from an important gang.
Gang? What gang's that?
I think it's in a train.
Sounds like the bastards will be okay, look. Alert the lads on the rooftops. We'll take her out.
Thank you.
Nabby.
Oh, please.
There's a whole gang out to get you.
No, some idiot can't even follow me proper.
No, they're dangerous. There might be an ambush in the station.
Timmy be daft.
I must get to the station before Agnes does.
Whatever happens, do not panic.
Who's following Agnes.
Who are you?
Nigel Bumble.
Why were you following us?
I want to join your gang.
Ah, oh, for Christ's sake, he knows who we are now.
All right, laddie. I can use you to tidy up the train a bit, if you didn't mind getting dirty.
Really? Terrific! You won't regret it, miss.